go faster.
What is this, an origami jeep?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
So here it is, the Jeep that I recently designed that I'm going to teach in this tutorial. It was inspired by a request from my student Dexter during a Zoom tutoring session. So for this particular Jeep that I used in the intro, I folded from a 6-inch square origami. And it's really cool because it can do backflips. And front flips. They should really be wearing their seatbelts. But for this tutorial, for clarity, I'm going to use a 10-inch square origami. So it'll end up looking something like this. And it won't really jump so well. And special for my members only, I have a tutorial for how to fold this little person that can sit in the Jeep, and it has articulated arms and legs. And to become a member, there's the info. And if you can't become a member, well, no worries. I have other people models that I've taught on this channel that can sit in this Jeep. And I'll have card links for those, which will appear in the upper right corner later in this video. Begin white side up, and we're going to make an 8x8 grid. So first, fold in half. Make really precise folds and crease sharply. This is a really challenging model, so if you're new to folding, I don't recommend this model. But if you're up for the challenge, let's continue. Unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. Fold the flap to the top. And repeat. Turn over, lift this crease up, and now fold it to the top. So it aligns with the top. And now flatten. So from the side, that's what it looks like. And now fold in half. And unfold. We have it divided into 8 in this direction. And now let's do this direction. Turn over, white side up. And unfold. Now, white side up. Fold this corner to the second intersection point. And repeat on the other 3 corners. Now fold this edge to the first crease. Hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And repeat on the other 3 sides. Unfold, and now fold this flap. How far? Well, we want this crease to align with this crease. So it's like that. Again, try to hold the layers down so that they don't slide. Okay, now rotate and unfold this flap. And now we're going to reverse fold right here. So push this point in like this, and you should have a flap here. Fold that flap down. So reverse fold is complete, and repeat. Fold it down. And repeat here. And one last time. Okay, and here we're going to do the same thing, but the flap is bigger. No big deal. Open here and pinch there and fold the flap down. Okay, make all of these folds nice and sharp. Now, unfold them just part way. Just enough so that you see all white. So it's like that. Now turn over, and we're just going to push right on this intersection point, right there. Boing. And do the same on the other three intersection points. There. And there. You might have to push here. And there. So you have the mountains and valleys like this, and now just collapse. You shouldn't have to reverse any creases. They should all be pretty much folded. And now you just have to collapse on the existing mountains and valleys. So it's... like that. All right, this right here is the front of the car, and this is the back. So let's turn over. So here's the front, here's the back. And now we're going to do a paper airplane fold, except we're not going to fold on the whole thing. We're just going to fold on this middle diagonal unit, one unit, right there. And repeat. Okay, and now rotate and turn over. So we have the front of the car right here. Now we're going to fold the front up so that these edges touch these edges. And this edge touches this edge. And now fold down on the existing crease. Now turn the page down like this and flatten. We're just making this crease for later. And bring it back up. Now rotate. So now we have the front of the car here, the back of the car here. Fold this flap up on this existing crease. So this is what it looks like from the side. Now fold this edge to the existing crease. Hold the layers down so they don't slide. now unfold this flap like this. So this is what it should look like from the side. Okay, front of the car, back of the car, the two sides. We're going to fold the two sides to the middle line. And this is a new fold. Okay, and now turn over. This is the front of the car, this is the back of the car. And here we have this rectangle here. We're going to bring these two edges together and just make them align and just pinch so that we make the diagonal one unit, like that, and repeat. And repeat here. So it's like this. Okay, now we're going to do a challenging step. We're going to reverse sink this whole area in here. So that means we have to push this part up. So open it a little bit. Now I have my hand here, I'm pushing on this rectangle from underneath, push it up, and now I'm going to push right here, push, 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 and that'll let me pinch along the diagonal, and now push up here and push in here, and I can pinch on this diagonal, like that. So it's like that, and here. So it's like that. And now turn over and hold these flaps down. Just like that. And same on this side. Okay, so here's the front of the car, here's the back of the car. We're going to make the seat. So we're going to close sink this edge inward, making this diagonal fold. So I recommend putting your finger right up against here, so when you push this point in, it'll be a little bit cleaner, maybe. So it's like that. That's not too bad. And repeat on this side. Okay, and now we're going to push this edge in. And there's the seat. I'm going to show you what it looks like from underneath. So you want to make sure that this flap goes in like that. It doesn't come out here, but it goes in there. Okay. And now we're going to work on the windshield. So let's pinch these two edges together. Push this in. Pinch, 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 like that. And repeat. Okay, so now the wheel is kind of in like that. We want it to come out. So what we're going to do is reverse fold it back out so that these two creases align with these two edges. so it's like this. And repeat on this side. Okay, now a little sneak preview. The way that this is going to close, these flaps can go to this side like this, and this is going to fold back, and we're going to do something so that the wheels don't end up folding back as well. Now the problem is that when we do this, you see how this opens up and it just doesn't really look so good. So I figured out a way to cover that and make it look really nice, but it's a tricky fold, so I'm going to try to show it to you. But if you can't do it, then just remember you can just close it like this, and that's good enough. Okay, but here's the difficult fold. What we're going to do is open here and reverse sync this flap. So here, just push it out like that. And there it's out. And now bring it over like this. And now fold this edge to the crease. So it's like that. And fold this flap like this. And now fold this flap inside the pocket. So this is what it looks like underneath. Okay, and let's repeat that on this side. So here we go. Reverse sync this point, open it up, and just push it out. Bring this flap over like this. Fold to the crease. Fold this flap like that. And fold this flap into the pocket. Okay, so here you could fold this behind and maybe it looks a little better, but you're probably thinking, no, it doesn't look any better. But this is what we're going to do, is just pull it open a little bit. So then you see how that lines up perfectly, like that, almost perfectly anyway. And this is what it looks like from underneath. Now we can just flatten it like that. So we're making a new fold. We're folding this edge to the flap. Like that. And it doesn't need to flatten all the way up there. Just let it just kind of do whatever up there. The important thing is it looks clean from the outside. So, yeah, you could even make it overlap a little bit if you want. I don't know, but I like it like that. And this is going to fold inside. Remember, don't fold the wheels. Okay. And repeat on this side. So you pull it out like that. But we want it to flatten. So we're making a fold like this. Voila. Okay, what should we do next? How about the back? So let's first push this in, like that, and repeat. Now fold this edge to the crease. But just fold one unit, one diagonal unit, like that, crease it, and unfold, and repeat. Unfold, and now open this, and just flip it out, like that. And make the two creases. And now pull the raw edge out. So reach in, pull the edge out, reverse this diagonal crease, like that, and like that. And there is the back. Okay, now we're going to work on the headlights. Well, almost. Let's first get rid of this white triangle here. What we're going to do is open here and fold this edge so that it aligns with this edge. Pinch, pinch, pinch right there. And just extend that fold so that it goes to here. It's not going to go all the way up to this edge. We're not going to completely get rid of the white triangle. But that's pretty good. And repeat. Okay, now it's time to work on the headlights. Okay. So what we're going to do is first fold it up. Which way do we go? Oh yeah, okay. All right, so what we're going to do is first bring these two flaps up like this so that these two edges align with this edge. And now fold them down. Okay, repeat on this side. So the two edges go to the crease. And fold them down. Okay, now fold this single flap, the front flap, up to the crease that we just made there. And we want that to be square. And unfold and reverse fold it. So pinch right there, pinch, and close it. And now fold on this existing crease, bring this edge up, open this pocket, just put your finger right inside there, and squash it. Squash this edge to this edge so that you end up with a 2x1 rectangle. 2x1 white rectangle, which is the headlight. Like that. And repeat. So here we go. Fold it up like this. Unfold. And reverse fold. Fold up here, put your finger in the pocket, and squash it. Like that. Headlight is complete. And now we just need to round the wheels. And you're kind of on your own here. We're trying to make an octagon. You could just try to make it a circle, but we're just mountain folding the corners behind, trying to estimate an octagon. So, when you fold these, you want these three lengths to be equal. So just fiddle with the folds until they look equal and octagonal, like 45 degree angles. Okay, and okay, and now this one. Not bad. Not perfect, but good enough. There's no folds on here. Seamless wheel. Okay, and repeat on the back side, the back wheel. Okay, and repeat on this side, and I'm going to fast forward this part. Okay, so like this, you can just kind of hide this behind and you're done. But the problem is that when you do that, the wheel kind of wants to go under as well and fold. So this is a really challenging step, but I'm going to show you how to do it. But just know that if you can't do it, well, you can just do that and you're sort of looking good. So what you do is open this pocket right here and open it so that you have try not to put creases in the wheel. Open here, and you have this pyramid here, and you want to sink the pyramid. So it's right here, just push it in. Like that. And that'll make it a little bit better, but to make it even better, if you can change these two folds so that they extend to this point, then you can fold this flap even further inside. So here goes. I'm going to just pull. I'm pulling here and pulling here. Pull that apart so that the folds extend like that. And that is challenging, and it's not going to be perfect in there, but at least you'll be able to fold this in there. Like that. You see, it doesn't affect the wheel so much. This is kind of like stubborn origami designing. I want it like this. I want it to be looking good, at least on the outside. Okay, and repeat. So here we go. Open here, and there's the pyramid. Push it in. And now extend these two folds to here. Just pull. Good enough. And there you have it. And repeat on this side, and I'm going to fast forward this part. Okay, so that's what it looks like. And if you want, you can cover up this white by reverse folding this flap. So unfold it and push it inside. And now you can just kind of fold this over so that it covers a little bit more white. Like that. And repeat. That way it looks just a little bit better underneath. And now just shape it. If you put a clip on this and dampen it, then let it dry, then it'll probably stay down really well. But I'm just gonna press it with my fingers and hope it stays a little bit. Yeah, that's decent. And there it is. Now to make it jump, now I'm not sure that this is going to jump. But what you do is you press down here and it flipped on its hood. Okay, the big one doesn't really jump, but check this out. This is the little guy. And from 6-inch paper, it really does flip. And it backflips too. And it can drive super fast. All right, hope you guys were able to fold this. I know it's a super challenging model, but I know a lot of you guys are super advanced. So there's an advanced origami model for you guys.
Here with Dexter, and he requested that I try to remake the Jeep from the 12-hour marathon. And this was my attempt at doing that. So it was kind of a fail. But then I later sat down and really tried to remake it, and I remade a whole new Jeep. And this is the one that I'm going to teach on the channel right now. Ready, set, here goes. Kairos and I folded Jason Kuz and Dominus Rex. It took about 10 sessions, but here it is. Yeah, that's good.
So for this particular Jeep that I used in the intro, I folded from a 6-inch square of kami. And it's really cool because it can actually do backflips.